Good evening, CLC. Thank you so much for joining me here this evening. I'm Naomi Feda, and I hope you have enjoyed this February storm that we've gotten. I know my kids are super excited to have lots of snow on the ground. Of course, it's one of the first that we've had so far this season. So today I'm going to be in Matthew chapter 25, which maybe you've heard of this, referred to as the parable of the talents. It's definitely one that I've heard frequently, but there's always some good nuggets of truth to be found in it again. So I'm going to read a couple of verses from that. It starts in verse 14. This is Matthew 25, verse 14. It says, "Again, the kingdom of heaven can be illustrated by the story of a man going on a long trip. He called together his servants and entrusted his money to them while he was gone. He gave 5 bags of silver to one, 2 bags of silver to another, and 1 bag of silver to the last, dividing it in proportion to their abilities, and he left on his trip." Now, before I even go further, just think about how easy it is for us in our own human nature to look around at the people who we think have been given more talents than us or more responsibilities, whether it's in terms of work and having more income, or if it is in terms of just the things that we are doing for the kingdom of God, whether it's, somebody that is overseas or someone that is publishing albums. It might seem like they have a bigger responsibility or have received more talents. And then, if you look at your ordinary everyday life, how often, or how easy it might be to say, well, what do I have? I haven't been given any talents. And yet, truly, that's not what God says. God has given all of us talents, all of us gifts and abilities, but also responsibilities. So I think of it even in terms of, what is our sphere of influence? Even if it's just that one talent or that one responsibility, maybe God has given you just the responsibility of your children, of stewarding them and raising them, investing them, or a neighborhood, a community, a workplace. And these are not to be taken for granted, because God can use us anywhere if we're available to Him, and He's put us in seasons and places for such a time as this. And one of the things that I know my spiritual father taught me so much is just be available, be expectant and prepared. And God has opportunities available to us. And whether it is that, rather than engaging in workplace drama, we're available to listen. We're available to sit with the coworker who's hurting, rather than be the one pointing fingers at another one. There's so many examples of how Jesus, as a man, was an ordinary person, and he really sat with people and he cared about them, and that is so important. I mean, if you even look at the example of Jesus living on earth, think how, from a secular perspective, it may not have seemed like he had been given a lot of quote unquote talents, meaning he wasn't in a high role of authority in the temple. He was the son of a carpenter. And yes, he was absolutely the son of God, empowered by the Holy Spirit, but that wasn't necessarily what he was seen as in the earthly realms, especially before he entered that realm of ministry where he began healing and teaching large crowds. So wherever it is, whatever place God has put you in today, in the season of your life, I just encourage you to be faithful with that. Don't take it for granted. Don't count it as too small. Because God absolutely rewards the faithfulness in the small things. And you can do so much good for the kingdom of God in those everyday places. So God bless you, and look forward to seeing you here again next week. Be sure to check us out in person at 20 West Main Street in Catskill, meeting at 10:30 on Sunday mornings. We'd love to see you there.